Welcome back. I hope you've been doing the exercises. In this tutorial, we'll continue with the theme of making your videos more professional looking by animating your media and adding video effects to bring attention and interest. Last time, we added transitions to this arrow to make it appear and disappear smoothly. One thing we can do to add a little more pizzazz is to have the arrow come in from farther away, like that. To start, go up to the Animations tab. We've been in the Animations tab before, but just when we were looking at creating zooms and pans. However, animations are much broader. They allow us to change pretty much any of the clip's properties over a period of time. For this first example, let's push the playhead where we want the animation to start, then grab the blank animation and drag it down to the clip. Yes, I know, blank sounds very uninteresting and not useful, but it is the most flexible. It allows you to do essentially anything you want. So, we added the animation. Let's just adjust where it happens by dragging it over a bit. And shortening it by dragging the red diamond slightly to the left. Now you'll notice that when we play it back, the animation doesn't do anything yet. All we see is the fade in transition. To make it useful, we'll need to change the arrow in some way before or after the animation. Since it's already where we want it to end, we're going to make a change before by moving the playhead in front of the animation, and in the canvas, dragging the arrow to where we want it to start. Now as we move the playhead through the animation, the arrow moves across the screen. There, that looks nice. Remember, as with transitions and other effects, be sure that the animations you use do their job of directing viewer focus or adding interest without distracting from the content you're trying to show. In this next example, we're going to use both animations and effects. Down here a ways, instead of highlighting the words on the video like we have now, let's display text to the side while still showing this part of the recording. We'll no longer need these annotations, so let's delete them. Next, since there's already an animation there, we'll just use it instead of adding a new one. As with all animations, we can alter them to our liking on the canvas, as well as any of the properties in the Properties pane. There's a lot of possibilities open to you. Let's move the playhead after the animation, where we want to make the change, drag the media across the canvas to show the relevant section, and just to add interest, let's tilt it in a bit by changing the Y rotation slightly. Now, we have a little problem. Our dark video blends into the dark canvas color, though that's easily fixed in the same place we changed the canvas size. In the Canvas Zoom dropdown, select Adjust Canvas, click on the colored box here, choose something light, like white, and click Apply. Now, scrubbing through it, you'll see that the animation shifts the clip to the side and tilts it in a bit, leaving us with some space for text, or another video or image. Okay, the clip looks fine, but still a little flat against the white, so let's look in the Video Effects tab. These effects change how media looks instead of how it moves or changes. Reflection might work, but I'm going to see what else is available. How about Drop Shadow? This will probably give us the effect we want. It doesn't really work as is, but we can tweak what it looks like. Let's look in the Properties to the General tab, where the Video Effects properties always are, down here in the Drop Shadow section. The first problem with the default settings, in this case, is that the shadow is pointing the wrong direction. So let's rotate the angle to have it show up on the left side, where it is visible. That's better, but it's a bit harsh, so let's make a few more adjustments. Increase the offset, how far away the shadow is, to bring it more off the background. Increase the blur and drop the opacity, which is the opposite of transparency, a bit to soften it. And then we preview it. Excellent. These are a couple of examples of how to use animations and effects to add interest to your video. Your turn. Go ahead and experiment in your own project or the example project. Use animations to move things around and change various properties, as well as add different video effects. See what will work for you. but for the next lesson, I'm also going to add some text annotations next to the part we move to the side. When you're done, be sure to join me back in the next tutorial on maintaining a consistent look and feel.